Residents of a Frankston apartment block are shocked and angry after being told to abandon their homes. Council claims they're such dangerous death traps that no one can spend another night in them.
Ordered out of their homes with less than 24 hours' notice.
I can't be on the street in a tent with three children.
Residents of Pinehill Drive were issued with an emergency evacuation order at 10 o'clock last night.
Incredible timing at the death knock of going to bed to find out that we're to be evacuated by 5 p.m. today.
Newlyweds Erin and Jared Taylor are also in disbelief.
We pay our rent always on time, if not early. We look after the place, we do everything right, and now we're being treated like we've done something wrong.
The builder's shoddy work, plain to see, exposed wiring, waterlogged ceilings and stairwells that are a fire trap.
When we got the first eviction order, I was almost too scared to turn on a light switch in case it got electrocuted or something.
A far cry from the real estate ads, the dangers overlooked by a dodgy building surveyor the local council has had trouble with in the past.
Do you not then have a duty of care to say, hold on, this guy might be dodgy, he might actually be putting lives at risk of people that live in my municipality?
The responsibility for the licensing of private building surveyors rests with the Building Commission.
The apartment block is now in the hands of receivers, yet to offer any kind of compensation. The residents reluctantly packing up, despite most not knowing their next move.
I can't give a personal guarantee that these people will have a roof over their head tonight, no.
We came to Australia for a fair go, as Australians like to say, and we don't think we've had it.
Hermione Kitson, 10 News.
And Hermione joins us live now from Frankston. And Hermione, residents had less than 24 hours to make up their minds. What have they now decided to do?
Well, Helen, that 5 p.m. deadline has now passed and residents are being urged to leave as soon as possible. Now, the lucky ones, they have family and friends close by they can stay with, but many other residents are still frantically trying to find emergency accommodation. The council says it's taking this matter very seriously, and those residents who continue to ignore this emergency evacuation face fines of up to $10,000. So, Helen, obviously a lot to think about for these Frankston residents here, obviously left homeless tonight, but they have decided to stand united in their very strong fight for adequate compensation.
All right, thanks for the update, Hermione. Hermione Kitson reporting live there from Frankston.